Hi, welcome to Tech Topics. My name is Matt, I'm an SRE with Nutanix, and today I'm gonna cover two topics, redundancy factor and replication factor. I'm gonna start with redundancy factor. So what is redundancy factor? Well, we define redundancy factor as the number of components that can be down in your Nutanix cluster at any one time plus one. So if you wanna set a redundancy factor of two, you can tolerate any one component being down, and if you wanna set a redundancy factor of three, you can tolerate any two components being down. So let's look at what we have on the board here. We're showing components as being either NICs, disks, or nodes. So if we had a redundancy factor of two, you could have a NIC go offline, a single disk go offline, or an entire node go offline. That might not be good enough for some people, especially in an enterprise environment. So if you want to be able to tolerate more component failures, you'd want to set your cluster up with a redundancy factor of three, which you could also have these three things go offline, and in addition, you could have a second disk fail, you could have a second NIC fail, or a second node fail. And you can mix and match which two components fail at the same time in your cluster. Before you can set a redundancy factor of three in your cluster, there are a number of requirements that must be met. The first requirement is you need to have five nodes. The reason we have to have five nodes is because we require five zookeeper hosts in your environment. So in this environment here, assuming these aren't failed, this could be a zookeeper host, this could be a zookeeper host, and then these three could be all zookeeper hosts. And that would meet the minimum requirement for redundancy factor three. In addition to having five nodes, each CVM needs to be configured with 24 gigabytes of RAM. That's just from a performance perspective, we require that additional overhead to handle the additional requirements for a redundancy factor of three, because we do replicate our metadata five times in a redundancy factor three cluster. Now, once you've verified that you've met these requirements, you're able to go ahead and configure your redundancy factor three cluster. There's two places where you can set this up, and can only be done before the cluster is first created. You can either set it up in the cluster init page via, there's a little text box in there that says cluster max redundancy factor, or you can define it at the command line with the dash dash redundancy underscore factor flag when you're using your cluster create command. Now we're gonna talk about replication factor. Replication factor is directly tied to what the redundancy factor is configured for on your cluster. If you have a redundancy factor of two set for the cluster, the only option for replication factor on your containers is two. If you have a redundancy factor of three on your cluster, your containers can either be a replication factor of two or three. Now, what is replication factor? Replication factor, simply put, is just the number of times any piece of data is duplicated on the system. So if you have a replication factor two container, that piece of data is going to be written twice somewhere in your cluster. It's not block aware, so it could occur twice on the same block, or once on this block and once on another block, so on and so forth. So you might have a piece of data written here, and then a second piece of data for that container written here. Now let's say you've set up a replication factor three container. That replication factor three container is going to replicate your data here, maybe here, and then over here. So what does all this mean? Going back to what we kind of covered with redundancy factor, it directly defines the number of components that you can lose on your system for that container. So if you had the replication factor two container, you could only tolerate losing this disk and not another disk in the system, because you don't know where that second piece of data is going to exist. But if you have a replication factor three container, you could not only lose this disk, but you could lose this other disk, assuming that piece of data is there. And then you know that the third replication of that data is going to be somewhere else in the cluster, so you're not at risk for any data loss. So how do you define what the replication factor is for a container? Well, there's two ways to do that. The first way is in Prism. You can either open your container properties and update it in Prism to three, or when you first create a container, you can set it to whatever you want your replication factor to be, either two or three. The other way to do it is from the Nutanix command line interface with the RF option when you're creating your container. Something to keep in mind too is that you can also change the replication factor of a container dynamically depending on whether or not you want maybe a certain container that might house more important data to be replicated three times. And our curator scans will take care of handling the replication in the background. So once you've set up your replication factor on your containers, there's some things to consider. There's a number of performance impacts, and there's also space utilization considerations that you have to keep in mind when you're first creating these things. That information, in addition to everything else that I've covered in this tech topic, is covered in the slides, which are available via the link at the bottom of this video. Thank you for tuning in, and I'd like to encourage you to check out some of the other videos in this series.